Following the closure of Uzima University School of Medicine in Kisumu, the school is set to give a press briefing on the way forward regarding the directive. A multi-pronged EAC health delegation had on Saturday ordered the institution to seek alternative admission slots for its 300 students after it was red flagged for non-compliance with the EAC guidelines. The joint health team is moving across East Africa member states to streamline the syllabuses and curb medical malpractices within the region. Laura Tenor is in Kisumu with the latest. Laura, what option are the students left with at the end of the day?
Well, Zinzi, the only option is for the students to wait for directives from the university's administration, because they were directed to redistribute the 300 students within this institution to various medical colleges or universities that offer medical courses and were certified to have qualified by that joint health team from the East African community. And it's not only Kenya, because in Uganda, top four colleges are also instructed to close down for failing to meet the minimum requirements. And Uzima University specifically was flagged down for allegedly not having enough staff in terms of the teaching staff. Also, they were flagged down for conducting their lectures in incomplete buildings and a host of other allegations as well, which that joint team from the EAC had given the university 6 months to comply with those regulations. They had indicated that there will be another inspection within 6 months. But then, Zinzi, this is opening up an entire conversation on the crackdown on universities and the entire health sector, because there have been various complaints of malpractice and what the EAC was basically doing, according to the agreement that they had last year in a convention they had in Nairobi, was that East African member states have to streamline their syllabuses to ensure that the practice is uniform across all member states, so that there can also be some sort of exchange program that medical students that were trained in Kenya can practice within the East African community, and the other students from other countries as well will be free to practice in Kenya. There were other universities as well that were instructed to upgrade their infrastructure by the end of 6 months. Some of them had up to 64%, 61%, including Kenyatta University and Moi University as well. They were not exactly closed down, but they were instructed to upgrade their infrastructure and their teaching staff to ensure that they match standards and regulations set by the East African community. So right now, the management of the university, that's Uzima University, is in a closed-door meeting, but they're expected to give a press briefing, because we had spoken to the VC earlier, and he was saying that he's confident that the university meets the required threshold, and therefore we're waiting to see what he will be saying in terms of whether they will be transferring the 300 students that are within this institution, or they will be holding on to their stand that they are still qualified, and how they will be presenting their petition to perhaps the Ministry of Education, the Department of Higher Learning, and also how they will be appealing their case to the joint health team within the East African community. The inspections were held in March, sometime earlier in March, and the team had come from Uganda, and in April they will be moving to Tanzania for the same crackdown. And as I said earlier, they are weeding out institutions that are not up to standard in terms of offering quality training. But Uzima University insists that ever since its inception, it has graduated 24 medical doctors, and they're receiving proper feedback from the ground. So of course, those are some of the things that we are waiting to hear direct from the host's mouth, and how exactly they will be presenting their petition to the Ministry of Education, and how they intend to move the conversation forward in terms of upgrading their infrastructure to ensure that they're up to standard with the EAC regulations and also the minimum basic requirements for higher education in the country, Zinzi.